Eating disorders have been prevalent in this country for years. Tracey Gold, who is best known as Carol Seaver on Growing Pains, has been traveling to college campuses speaking about her battle with anorexia.
Hi, Tracey. How are you tonight?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm very good. So when you were 12 years old, how did the eating disorder develop?
Well, it started when I was 12, and I always kind of call it like I had a bout with anorexia when I was 12, and it just really was not so much about weight. I don't even think I thought about weight at 12. It was more about I was fearful of kind of growing up, and I think 12 and puberty and all of that sort of stuff, a lot of changes were happening, and I think my natural reaction was I just kind of stopped eating because I wanted to stay young and small and all of that, and I thought that by, you know, kind of letting that next stage of your life happen, that meant that I'd be like, you know, moving out of the house and living on my own soon, and all that was very scary. So it was basically just kind of over a summer, and I got better without any treatment at that point, and just sort of kind of got better to make everybody else kind of like stop being on my back and being upset and all of that.
When did your family and friends start to notice that something wasn't quite right?
Well, at that time, it wasn't really family and friends. It was mostly, my parents' friends were saying things to them. But for me, it was more just my parents were really on me, and I went to a pediatrician. It was very small at that time. It was very, just kind of like, you know, a doctor saying, look, looks like anorexia, and, you know, but it wasn't big like it got when I was older.
And how long did it take you to recover from this?
I would buy, it was summer, and by the end of the year, like after Christmas, you know, it kind of just went away, really. It was like that. And probably that's why I came back with such vengeance when I was older, because it wasn't really treated, and it just came back very strongly because it wasn't really dealt with.
And when you relapsed at age 19, what pressures did you face that caused the relapse?
Well, I think there were normal pressures of, you know, looking a certain way and being thin. And there was also pressures, you know, 19, like, you know, your life is changing and you guys are all going through that, you know. It's you're kind of in that here nor there place. And Growing Pains was, you know, kind of starting to wind down, and relationship, you know, boyfriends. I met my husband at that time, so things became very big at that point in my life.
And how long did the show continue to run until the producers said, like, you needed to be treated?
I would say I was suffering from an eating disorder 2.5-3 years before somebody said something. Started to really take drastic action, because I had an eating disorder for a full year and maintain a weight, which can be tricky because you don't really see it. You know, I was doing all this weird eating stuff, but it was definitely starting to feed into the eating disorder and take me down that road. But I was maintaining a normal weight, so I could kind of hide it at that point. And then I would say from 90 on, from 90 to 92, my weight just really plummeted, and then by the beginning of 92, that's when it became, or the end of 91 actually, became very apparent, and I was told to gain weight.
And how low did your weight get in that period?
You know what, I am, through my years of talking about eating disorders, I've really learned not to talk numbers. In the beginning I did, and through kind of my own education, I think that talking about numbers becomes really detrimental for other girls, because my low number, my high number, all those things can be very different for each girl. And I think once you start to put numbers on it, it can play real tricks with other girls. And I try and stay away from that.
And on this show, how did the writers disguise your leave of absence in the plot?
I went to Europe. So, you know, the truth was there were only 3 episodes left of Growing Pains in its entirety. It was going to end in March, and this was January, so, you know, we only had a few episodes to shoot, and I missed 3 episodes in total, and I came back for the last episode still really sick, but, you know, it was 3 weeks I missed.
How supportive was the cast?
The cast was tremendously supportive. In particular, Joanna, who played my mom, she, I found out later, was instrumental in going to Warner Brothers and the producers and saying, you know, something needs to be done. So I was surrounded by a lot of love and support at that time.
Do you still keep in contact with any of them?
Oh, absolutely. Everyone is, like, super... I mean, close. We're close. I take that back. We keep in contact on and off, but we're very close in the sense that if we see each other, it's all great, but, you know, our lives are all very busy also.
And one last question for you. Do you have...
On and off, but we're very close in the sense that if we see each other, it's all great, but, you know, our lives are all very busy also.
And one last question for you. Do you have any new projects in the works?
I do. I have a huge project in the works on eating disorders, and it's for a popular women's network. I can't mention the network yet, but it's sort of along the lines of an intervention, but with eating disorders.
Okay, well, thank you for having me on the program.
All right, thank you.
Have a good day.
Thanks.
That was Tracey Gold, best known as Carol Seaver on Growing Pains.